This is part two of our tutorial on creating and running Bootable backups. In part one, we got a basic Bootable backup system in place. Here we present a few configuration options that you may want to consider. The first is to enable archiving of replaced files. Turning this option on in the setup panel is very simple. When on, any file on your Bootable backup drive that gets replaced by a more recent file will get moved to the archive instead of being overwritten. The archive is a special folder on your destination drive where older files get placed. You can retrieve these older files from the archive panel of your Bootable backup sync document. You can fine-tune the behavior of the archive so it consumes a minimal amount of disk space. For example, you can enable compression to reduce the size of archived files. Other archive management options are explained in the context-sensitive help pages. The next configuration option to consider is the automatic mounting and dismounting of your Bootable backup volume. It is always possible that a so-called rogue application or inadvertent user action could wipe out data on your backup drive. Keeping it offline prevents this from happening. To automatically mount your backup volume when running a Bootable backup and dismount it when done, click Options on the destination target. Enable the Attempt to Mount Volume and Dismount Volume after Synchronization options. With these settings in effect, your backup volume will only be online when a Bootable backup operation is running. The next configuration option to consider is the disabling of Spotlight on your Bootable backup volume. Having Spotlight index the contents of your Bootable backup is generally not desirable. The overhead incurred by spanning the files can slow down the Bootable backup operation. To disable Spotlight, open System Preferences and click the Spotlight icon. Switch to the Privacy tab and click the plus button. Select your Bootable backup volume in the sidebar. This prevents Spotlight from scanning the files on your Bootable backup drive. The last configuration option to consider is to split up your Bootable backup operation into two distinct tasks. Previously, we stated that having a Bootable backup run at a scheduled interval without human interaction was not recommended. However, backing up your data files at regular intervals is highly recommended. You can easily split your Bootable backup task into two parts, one that backs up your operating system and another that backs up just your user data files. To do this, you begin by right-clicking your Bootable backup sync document in the document organizer and choosing Duplicate from the pop-up menu. You then modify this duplicated sync document to back up only the user's folder. We then edit the duplicated document to begin our modifications. To narrow the scope of the backup, we switch to the Analyze panel and select all entries except the user's folder. We then right-click the selection and choose Exclude from the pop-up menu. Save the changes and run the synchronization. Only the user's folder, which contains each account's home folder and data files, will be backed up by the sync document. Since this sync document is the one that will capture daily changes to our data files, we go ahead and schedule it to run frequently. In this example, we're having it run daily at 4:30 p.m. While you could leave things the way they are now, we're going to perform the opposite modification on the main Bootable backup sync document. This will prevent the Bootable backup task from backing up any user data that may change in between runs. We want it to be responsible for operating system files only. To run a complete Bootable backup that includes operating system files and user data files, you could run both of these synchronizer documents separately. To make the process more cohesive, however, we're going to combine them into a single container document. Since a single container will perform a full system backup, we give it the name Full System Backup. We then switch to the Documents panel and drag the individual synchronizer documents in from the Document Organizer window. Now when we run the container document, both the operating system and user data backups will run in sequence, as if they were a single backup task. You would do this when you want to manually invoke a full system bootable backup, but don't want to bother with invoking each synchronizer document separately. This concludes our tutorial on creating, running, and customizing bootable backups. For more information, visit the product resource pages on our website or drop us a line via the support form. We'll be happy to help you build a custom solution that meets your needs.